entering turn three in the clockwise direction.
Sunset looks amazing.
Brent Johnson, your pole man. And away we go. Good start from O'Rourke and being pushed by Hammond. The tan machine. Killer Oakley's head gets through. Second run, he leads them out of turn number two. And up the back straight for the first time. O'Rourke moves into second. And it's Johnson. And it might be
Cunningham back there.
Daniel Cunningham, 15 car. Looking for Wayne Brown Johnson. Out of turn number four. Right up on the wall, might be the 86, and here's Colin Kenny.
Yeah.
He paints the big car, looks real sharp, next level.
Yeah, the 2 men at the front entry.
Steve Harvey trying to find his way through as well. He's up to about 4th and 5th place. That's the blue and black number 4 car. Doing a good job. Had a good run last time out as well. Hammond, though, leads the way. Rook 2nd, Cunningham. Then it's Steve Harvey, Davison, Acton. Then the 67 machine, and that is...
Yeah, Parsons. And back to Colin Kenny. Russell doing an awesome job. But our leader, it is all Matt Hammond, sets Parsons lap the race at a 19. The only one in the 19. David O'Rourke's next. One consolation final recently was absolutely over the moon with it. And why would you be? Some of the chocolates. Steve Harvey now moves on Daniel Cunningham. Not quite. Well, they are now at half race distance, and now Harvey on maximum attack. Looking for the way past David O'Rourke as they fire down the top sheet that'll back straight up towards the meat mount area. Turn three in reverse direction. O'Rourke keeping Harvey at bay. O'Rourke, bit of understeer. Runs wide on the track now, gets down right. Covers that line beautifully as Hammond. Got some 6 seconds gap back to O'Rourke, doing an amazing job out in front with a couple of laps remaining.
He's just smashed him as he hit the 10 car, Dylan Earthworks entry. Challenge again, second place, Steve Harvey working over David O'Rourke and they come out of turn number four and only two to go. Harvey challenging pretty much everywhere and he needs to because Cunningham is dropping on him, also wants to buy back into it.
He certainly does. Quite glad that having a bit of a battle with Steve Parsons as the white flag is out Friday. And Matt Hammond has been a masterclass in street stock racing. Oh, contact there. O'Rourke gets given the short back and sides. It was checkered flag. Matt Hammond, Hammer time, takes the win. Strong win at that. Great start. Collins comes through to second, will beat Steve Harvey. Daniel Cunningham, David O'Rourke. Oh, you've got to love the streeties.
Absolutely sensational. As we get set to go, cars coming out of turn four for Russell. On pile, it'd be tough to beat from there, but Terry Hammond wants a piece of it straight away as they work up into turn number one for Russell, Terry Hammond. Then it's Matthew Atkinson. It's a lot of Matthew. He ran his first show last week in Carrick. It was a good show. Ben Ryan is there in the 24. Always there and thereabouts, isn't he, Ben Ryan?
Oh! Bit of contact back in the back.
Spacing out towards the pit fence. Oh, number two is Terry Hammond, who made a great start last time as we go green again. Now, who gets the better of it this time? Russell, Matthew Atkinson, who's made a better start. Hammond looks to the inside. It's Terry Hammond. Brand new car.
Yeah, the big thing is when they went to cut the roof off the other one, that twist just sprung open. So he said, really looking forward to running tonight in a straight car. It runs wide. That's allowed the accountant, Ben Riley, in the black and white machine to move up into third position. Going back to Lucas Dickinson in 21, behind Tom Hammond, to Brett Henry behind them, and gap back to Margaret Bryan, Corey Maurice, and Matt Vessel at the back. You pick up Troy Russell, fire him off into the distance. Matt Atkinson trying to stay in touch with Russell, but we know what a big contender Troy Russell is. He is always a hard charger.
Yeah, he's very good at even coming right through the traffic in a big field. He's particularly good in traffic.
Caution.
Give him a front row start, and he's a very, very hard man to run down. That is turn number one.
Marcus Bryant.
Juniors at the end of last season into the senior divisions this season. Troy Russell gets us back underway. There is six laps to run. He leads the way from Macca Atkinson, who sits in second. Then it's Ben Riley. Keep your eye on Ben Riley. He's very, very good at working his way through. Always there and thereabouts.
He certainly is.
Atkinson, Riley, then it's Terry Hammond. Luke Dickinson will be the next one. Behind Dickinson will be Brett Henry in 84. You can't hit two. He's gone out of the early model VS Commodore up to a later model car. So lots of new cars coming out this season. Is Atkinson starting to put some pressure on Troy Russell?
He certainly is. He's had a sneaky little look up to the inside a couple of times. Had another one on the run into turn one. Could not get it done. Ben Riley back there, little lonely third position. Terry Hammond not too far behind him. Pick up the battle for the lead. You've got the hard charging Troy Russell out in front. Then we go back to Macca Atkinson looking to try and keep in contact. We know that Russell is a hard charger. And give him an inch of clear track and try and drive away. So Macca doing the top job, staying in contention with Russell. The gap under a second, then it's a long gap back to Ben Riley. 3 seconds, not far behind him is Terry Hammond. Bernie Dickinson having a lonely run. Oh, I put the commentator's curse on him down there in turn one. Had a bit of a moment, gathered it back together nice. Nice driving there. Brett Henry is behind him, then back to Matt Bessel. As we've got Wonder Travels driving.
Here we go, our race leader exits turn two. Works the back straight, Hammond and the Wiley Tulls in turn for the final time. Handy little break back to Atkinson. And it will be Troy Russell out to who takes the checkered flag and the win. Second will go to Atkinson and Riley home third. Then it's Terry Hammond, the 110 machine. Luke Dickinson will be next. Under some pressure though, Brett Riley. Brett Riley. Ben Henry. Try that again. Brett Henry.
I knew who he meant. Well, that's all that matters.
Yeah. Up in turn three, as it is in this direction. We're set to go. Green flag at the ready. And away we go. Allison and Crawford contact before they actually got the flag. More contact with Nick Taylor. Back in the pack. Battle second between Taylor and Crawford. They are absolutely going at it. Galloway's in there as well. And the 66, Nathan Russell. There's just little bits of contact going on right throughout the pack at the moment. Our leader though is Mitch Allison doing it nice and Crawford. Then it's Taylor, Nathan Russell, next one through, Sean Atkinson at 39, doing it nice. Then it's Galloway, back to Paul Ball, 77.
Brad Curran, Luke Williams and Big John, and they were ruffling his feathers.
Paul now leads the way in the 11th car. Nathan Russell, contact with Nick Taylor. Gee, Taylor's been in the wars.
Oh, he has. They use him like a motocross fighter against the bird. Bouncing off of the usually just banking on the outside.
Not with the pinball wizard. Crawford leads the way. The gap is 1.6 seconds. Nathan Russell now, fastest man on the track. And it's in traffic, putting a pass move on the Mitch Allison and run the back straight. Turn up three. Chance one. Nathan Russell gets through and touches up second place. Allison back to third. Like that ball because it looks like Sean Atkinson in 39 stuck down the inside, taking another spot.
He certainly has. Russell in hot pursuit. Fastest man on the track at the moment is our leader, the killer. So Matt Broughton is the 11th machine. He's just powering along out in front. And keep an eye back in the pack because Sean Atkinson trying to put the moves on Nathan Russell. And Goldie's on the charge. He's got past Mitchell.
Starting to move forward now. Then it's Brad Carr, John Riley, Tristan Galloway, Ford's the next one at 20.
We've lost Nick Taylor. He's travelling very slowly down here on the start finish straight.
Oh, yeah.
Rob,
yeah.
Wow. Yeah.
But it is checkered flag time. Great start of the night from that 4.11 car. Takes the win. Second will go to Nathan Russell. Good result for him from starting well back from the back four. All done in third. Then Sean Atkinson. We go back to Luke Williams, Mitch Allison, Brad Curran, John Riley, Tristan Galloway, Taylor Walker. Round it out.
Yeah.
Green flag at the ready, they're not wasting any time. This one brought to us by 7AD, 7BU and LAFM. Red flies, they come round, take the green. Dale Riley Jr. from the outside. Ah, red wide, hammer time. Look for the way through on the inside of Mel Collins. Plenty of contact there, then through the Nigel Apted as we pick up our leader. Dale Riley Jr., Terry Farrell is back there. Being a monster, I think he might be at the way through. Our leader, Dan Riley Jr., starts straight away with it. Terry Farrell in second. Nigel Apted is next, and back to Mel Collins. Matt Hammond tries to get through. Mel Collins, oh, a bit of bumper tag there on Apted, and loses the spot. Hammond says, I'll take that, thank you very much. Our leader, Dan Riley Jr., continues straight away. Some 3.4 seconds up the road from second place, Terry Farrell. Driving the wheels up, doing a superb job. Here we go back. Behind Terry Farrell, got the super hard charge from Matt Hammond. Hammond worked his way through, looking for an inside run on Terry Farrell. Couldn't get it done at that point in time. Lifts off, gets a bit of race through. Now tries to power down the concrete metal back straight. Glad to win it down. We're at half race distance here. And Dale Riley Jr., he's got a massive, massive lead over the length of the straight. That is phenomenal. Look at this battle for second, third, and fourth. Colin Kenny just barged through on Nigel Apted. Got to say, Kevin Merrill's doing a fantastic job of hanging on. He's under extreme pressure. And still, as they work their way up through turn three and four in this direction, he's hanging tough. Matt Hammond's right behind him, then Colin Kenny, Nigel Apted, David
O'Rourke's
there as well.
Well, Colin's in amongst it.
Yeah,
and 567
car, I think it is there.
That's Steve Parson.
Yeah, Steve Parson, he's moving forward as well.
Speaking of Parson, so there's a bit of a Parson move going on at second place.
Oh, someone's made contact with the wall. It's David O'Rourke in 19, and turn number 4, hard up against the wall. Their race leader.
Stop racing. The pinball effect is coming into play. 5 laps remaining. Daniel Cunningham coming under intense pressure. Russell goes to the high line in turn one. Straight around the outside. Troy Russell, talk about take no prisoners. Steve Harvey tries to emulate him. Couldn't get it done. We've got one around facing the wrong way. Down here in turn two. That is the six car.
5 laps to run. In heat 5.
Just by Wiley Thomas.
Matthew Atkinson is your leader, coming out of turn 4. And away we go. What's got to have done until Troy Russell has closed down that gap. He's had a couple of seconds prior to stopping. He's right in back now as they exit turn 2 and work the back straight. And put the gap on third place coming in. He's got Steve Harvey with him and leads Ben Riley around the outside. And there's Ben Riley in 24. So the leader's still Macca. Russell, gap back to Ben Riley, Daniel Cunningham, Steve Harvey. Then we go back to the 92 car of
Steve Russell.
They're travelling around the state. Nothing to be submitted this season. Steve Russell, he's been up and about. As the challenge has come, Russell had a big look on the inside of Macca on the run into one that time.
He certainly did. We know that Russell is a hard charger. The Ironman event, and he's got plenty of toughness about him. Very tenacious, there's no doubt about that. He will look for the way through. One of the backmarkers, Darren Saunders, about to go past him. Oh, a bit of a moment there. So work out which way they're going. And both got four.
I was going to say that, fortunately, neither one got the advantage. They both sort of got checked up by, didn't they?
Yeah. That resumes the attack. They're on their last lap, right?
Not quickly, isn't it?
Yeah.
Macca, he's done a great job, actually. Deserves to win this. It's good suppression from one of the best. Takes the win. Second will go to Troy Russell and Ben Riley. The fast ties of Ben Riley, too, I might add, in 24. Got home third, then Steve Harvey. 14, the next.
Let's hope they put all those mechanical issues behind them now. Henry and Dickinson. Henry gets the jump at the line. Dickinson trying to go with him. Dickinson goes to the outside. That's a big bold passing move if he can pull it off. And he does. Oh, nice stuff there from Cody Dickinson. Hit the front. Brett Henry relegated back to second. Matt Vassell is the next one through. And we're keeping an eye on the white knight, Corey Ball. Crawford is there. The pinball effect is... 39 car of Sean Atkinson. So, Matthew Atkinson.
What's going on here? Some side by side and some nose to tail, but Dickinson gets away nicely. Henry sits in second. Corey Reese was third briefly. Nick Taylor's gone around the outside of him, as has Corey Ball now. But none of the white, the all-white car of Corey Ball, coming to 77. Galloway's down there on the infield, and with the leading there, and on his white ties to the edge of the track. Down there in the green and black 66. Dickinson, it leads the way we are, yellow.
Dickinson's got Casey's dad. Casey's, Ellis's better half.
People with
Supersedans and Northview would be. Yeah. Oh, they'd be a champion of the bit like Stallion on steroids.
Going to go this time. The green flag is waving and a win away. Good restart, Lucas Dickinson. To keep an eye on Nick Taylor and Corey Ball that slipped under the white machine of Brett Henry. And they're in hot pursuit now of Luke Dickinson. Down into the pit turn they come. They've still got to punch it.
They certainly have. 6 laps remain in this one. Lurdy Dickinson now under plenty of pressure from Taylor. Baldy is back there as well. Nip and tuck back in the pack as Baldy now up on the inside of Nick Taylor grabs second. Sits out after Dickinson. Looks passing move. heading into turn one. And you've got Matt Crawford back there behind Taylor. Crawford now gets Taylor. Ball now on the inside of Dickinson. Dickinson hanging tough, but Baldy, the white knight, gets it done.
Moves through into the lead, and now Dickinson's got Matt Crawford, who's made good progress in this race. Matt looked for second place, a little bit of contact there at the back of the 21 car. Dickinson, Nick Taylor is in the lead this game as well. So two of them now attacking the back of the youngsters, Blue, Commodore, out of turn number four. They come around and complete another lap. There is three to go. Corey Ball now has a bit of a lead. Dickinson is second, Crawford's third, then we've got Taylor. Behind him, it's Mitchell's rear bar flailing on that one. But it's going to be hard to see anyone getting Corey Ball. He's checked out. Dickinson, though, has got Crawford tapping on the rear bar, trying to find a way past. But to his credit at the moment, young Dickinson's done a terrific job.
He certainly has. Baldy, this wily veteran, he is experienced. Yo, dog! Corey Ball down in front. He's got a massive gap now. Was 2.2 seconds last time by. It's now out to 2.69. Dickinson's driving superbly. He's got the super charger killer. Earthworks man Matt Crawford all over him like sunburnt thighs on a vinyl car seat cover. Checkered flag time. Corey Ball takes the win. Looney comes home second.
Well, Taylor stole third on the line there.
By 5,000 seconds.
Very last minute. Corey Ball takes the win in the 77. Lucas Dickinson, good job from Young. The middle back straight, green flag being fed. We're set to go. Heat 7. This one brought to us by Alan Pickford's.
Careful movers, and we'll see if anyone's doing some careful moving.
Not too much careful moving,
the street stocks.
John Riley brings it to the line, and away we go, but wins. And he wasn't praying enough to try and get in there, so I do not blame him. He looks for the over and over, confident, done good. Side by side, the run of the back straight into turn number three. Williams on the inside, big job on the outside. Out of turn number four, they come in, they are leading away for each other. Curran is third, Dale Riley Jr., Carter Borden, Nathan Russell, Harry Orton, Terry Farrell, and Darren Saunders. And Williams has finally got that position.
Yeah, he certainly has. And he's trying to drive away with it. Big John trying to stay in contention. Do love the colour scheme. The colour scheme of Big John Riley's car. Brad Curran in third, he's closing in on the hard-charging John Riley. Dropped off Dale Riley Jr. and Nathan Russell by a bit. That's unusual. Russell back there in fifth. Trying to charge his way forward, but Luke Williams showed enough, nearly a one-second gap to beat John Riley in three laps. Four laps remaining, this time past the stripe in this eight-lap journey.
Luke Williams just establishing a nice little break back to John Riley. Current, Dale Riley Jr. and Nathan Russell, they're together in amongst that traffic. So this is where things can happen, things can go wrong, and things can go right, if you know what I mean. Williams points another lap, three to go in this one. John Riley, Current, Dale Riley Jr., Nathan Russell, those two have gone toe-to-toe a number of times over. Always turn on some great racing, and they are racing hard for position.
They certainly are. Luke Williams, it's the fastest lap of the race. Still a couple of laps from home. He's now established about 2.3 second gap. One for the 17, Matty Russell. So popped into them just briefly, but he's been born behind Curran and Riley Jr. Luke Williams, one to travel. The white flag is out. He's the man to this one. The interest for me is Brad Curran's got the hard-charging Dale Riley Jr. all over the back of him. And he's got Nathan Russell right behind him, current state champ. Looks the way through. Bit of bumper tag, but it's checkered flag time. Luke Williams takes the win. John Riley takes second. Great run there from Brad Curran. For third, Dale Riley Jr. in fourth. Nathan Russell in fifth. Alan Foreman in sixth. Back to Terry Farrell.
over 20 laps. Wheel to wheel, door to door. And Robin Nash, straight dogs. We love it. This one brought to us by Speedway Australia. 20 laps is the journey. Macca on pole. Macca and Russell. Russell goes to the high line, gets it done. Big bold outside passing move. Here comes Hannon up on the inside of Macca. This side by side, shoot down the back. Macca though hangs tough. Will not relinquish in second spot. Troy Russell is your leader. 19 laps remain.
And they most certainly do. Troy Russell just opens up a couple of car lengths off the back. Back in the pack, Dunno Riley Jr. passed about three cars on the way out of two and up the back straight. Awesome stuff. Burns himself up into second place. Back and tries to fight back on the inside. Hammond's there. Corey Ball's there. Steve Harvey's there. Are we yellow?
Yeah. Got one out against the concrete, which is a great car.
We're green!
Yeah, certainly are. And Russell's made a really good restart there. Already got a couple of car hits. By the time they got to the strike, leads the way. Worked the back straight. And comes under attack again. Matt Hammond's there, Corey Ball.
He certainly is. Troy Russell, though, got a very handy bumper. Here's the move from Hammond. He's trying to get it done, coming out of turn two down the back straight. Cannot get it done at that point in time. Macca hanging tough. Our leader hanging tougher. Here's the move once again from Hammond. Looks to try and get down on the inside. Going into turn one. He's got a cover though because Corey Ball right behind him. Macca Atkinson hanging tough out in second. Our leader Troy Russell. He has just gone off into the distance. But we are cautious. Stephen Harvey down here in the Wiley Tiles pit turn.
I didn't see that. They go Forest Hill well up.
Yes. And that is steep.
Yes. So we're set to go green. We've still got 17 laps to go to complete this street stock feature race. Troy Russell leads the field of the line. Macca, he's been under attack from Hammond the whole journey. Hammond really, really aggressive this time. Can he make work? No, he can't. Has to sit there in third for the ball. There's Arnold Jr. And we go back to, I think it might be Luke Williams, perhaps.
Luke Williams.
Then Ben Riley, Nathan Russell attacking him. Bit of contact. Oh.
Field. Thought there might have been more, but we're back racing. Troy Russell, Macca Atkinson, Matt Hammond, Hammer Time back there in third. Corey Ball in fourth. Oh, in fourth. Cleaner. Back from Dale Riley Jr. Luke Williams. Here comes Nathan Russell up on inside. Got the passing move done on Ben Riley. But he is deep in the back. Troy Russell heads him up.
Yeah, he's just been a little top class of his own in this one. And not that mistake with him. And I've got to say, Macca's doing a really good job on this restart. He's been under pressure the whole way from Matt Hammond. And that continues, but he's just driven beautifully. He's trying to stay with Troy Russell whilst defending his position from Hammond. But he's trying to defend his position from Corey Ball. Dale Riley Jr. is there. Now it looks like Nathan Russell starting to move up into this game as well. So the one car.
Caution!
Flame with yellow once again. Motorised mayhem. So, Troy Russell is declared your winner. Matt Atkinson comes home in second. Matt Hammond in third. Corey Ball, Dale Roberts Jr., Matt Russell, Luke Withers, Ben Riley, John Riley, Terry Hammond, Randy Anger, Tom.